What's up guys, this is your boy Dr. ZZ, and recently I had passed my PLAB 2 exams. I will put one of the links right over here. And I had done my PLAB 2 exams and I had passed the entire exam within one attempt. So today I want to talk to you guys about the most important skill that you need to pass your PLAB 2 exam in one go. Yes, the No. 1 most important skill. Are you guys ready for it? So the No. 1 most important skill that is extremely important to pass your PLAB 2 exams is interpersonal skills. There, I've said it. But wait, you don't believe me? That's fine. But you will definitely believe these guys. Here are some of the things that the examiners have to say about the exams. That we have assessed your knowledge in the part 1 exams and you will not gain marks for telling simulated patients all you know about a specific symptom or illness. You should concentrate on showing the examiners how you interact with the patient. Interpersonal skills. Look at what these other examiners have to say. Communication is key. You need to show that you understand the needs of the patient, relative or colleague, and understand their concerns, particularly if you're faced with an emotionally difficult situation such as a bereaved relative. You need to be able to show compassion and that caring for the person as an individual is of the utmost importance. And I think this can be quite tough for some candidate in the test environment. So that is something which is very important to understand. The main thing that they're looking for in you is how you interact with your patient, and that is interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills is something that can really help you up your game and improve your passing rates in your PLAB 2 exams. For you to understand this a little bit better, I have to tell you how the entire PLAB 2 exam is marked. So I'm going to talk about that right now. In the PLAB 2 exams, the way you're marked is you're marked on history, management, and interpersonal skills. The full marks for each of those are 4 marks. So history, the full marks would be 4. Management, full marks would be 4. Interpersonal skills, full marks would be 4. So the total marks for one station would be 12 when you add those 3 things up. Now, what is the pass mark for a single station? Now, usually you don't need to get 12 to pass a single station. Usually the pass mark is decided by the way on average how well the student performs. So if all the students perform really well, then your pass mark goes up. If most of the students perform poorly, then the passing marks goes low. So from the 12, you can expect a 6 to an 8 to be a passing mark. So it usually ranges between them. Sometimes 6.5 is a pass mark, sometimes 7. So if you're getting a score of around 7, you can make sure that you have passed that station. For you to pass the PLAB 2 exam, you need to do 2 things. No. 1, you need to pass 11 or more stations. There are total 18 stations in the exams, so you need to at least pass 11 stations. And No. 2, you need to get the minimum amount of marks that is required to pass. As I told you, the total marks for a single station is 12. Multiply that into 18, so the full marks is 216, which is impossible to get. So there is an average mark in total that you need to get. So there's an average total marks that you need to get to pass, and 11 stations that you need to pass. Let's say the average passing mark is around 130. Out of 216, you need to get 130. Let's say you have got 130 for that, but you have only passed 10 stations. You do not pass the PLAB 2 exams. What I'm trying to tell you is that you need to get both those things, 11 stations and get the minimum passing mark in total. That's why PLAB 2 exams can be so tricky, and that's why people tend to fail, because sometimes people have good marks but they have not passed enough stations. So our goal is to make sure we do both. Now, how can interpersonal skill help you to pass these exams within one go? Let me explain. You guys all have heard these things that PLAB 2 is rapidly changing and things get harder. That is true, because you end up getting newer cases and people don't know how to perform in them. But if you have great interpersonal skills, you can still pass those stations. Let me explain why now. A single station has history, management, and interpersonal skills. Let's say you are damn good with your interpersonal skills and you get a 4 marks over there. In that case, you only need to get probably a 2 in your history, or probably 1 in your management, which equals to 7 out of 12, which is pass. The reason I gave you 2 for history and 1 for management is keeping in mind that this is a new station and you don't know how to perform, but you're very good at interacting with the patient, so you definitely get a high mark and that for your interpersonal skill, and you pass this station. Now let's put another scenario. Let's say you're very bad with the interpersonal skill and you get a new station. So you get probably a 1 or a 2. Let's say you get 1 for interpersonal skills, and because it's a new station, your history is all messed up, so you get a 1 there. If your history is messed up, your management's messed up, so you get a 1 there, leading to what? A disaster. A 3, which is definitely a fail. That's why these examiners also look at how you interact with these patients, and that's one of the biggest key factors that can help you improve your passing rate and pass this exam in one go. But there is a problem. I thought that because I was good at interpersonal skills, everyone else was. For me, I was actually blessed. I mean, I have been trained in interpersonal skills and public speaking since I was a kid. I've taken part in many Model United Nations. In fact, I have put up this YouTube channel, grown it to almost around 7,000 subscribers, because I have good interpersonal skills and I can communicate with a wide range of audience easily. But I thought everybody had the same. So when I went for my PLAB 2 course, and now when I started doing one-on-one session, I realized that not everybody is very good with interpersonal skills. That is why I came out with my own course. I decided that I needed to design a course only focusing on interpersonal skills that can really help students to improve their interpersonal skill game. What I did was I actually came out with a webinar which had a lot of students, where I went into in-depth of how to improve your interpersonal skills and how to tackle specific scenarios and how your entire thing was. Some of the things that I covered in that interpersonal skills was confidence, first impression, body language, how to look at verbal and non-verbal cues, which are very important, how to sympathize and empathize properly instead of just saying, "I'm sorry to hear that," which is a stock phrase that examiners hate, how to communicate with patients clearly. I also spoke about some important stations and how to tackle those things. That was what helped a lot of my students who I did one-on-one classes with really pass these exams. After taking my course, they really understood what interpersonal skill is, and that really helped them improve their scores in their PLAB 2 and pass these exams. So lucky for you guys, that webinar was recorded, and since I had put so much work into it, I actually had to give it off to most of the people who can benefit from it. The webinar was sold at $55 at that time, but now I decided, you know what? You know, I'm gonna slash it even more. I want this webinar to be available and affordable for everybody who's doing PLAB 2, right? In the world of PLAB 2, where everything is expensive, starting from £100 and hundreds and thousands of pounds, you know, £600 for a PLAB 2 course, £800 for a PLAB exams, the entire PLAB journey itself cost you around $6,000. I wanted to make sure to price this course, I wouldn't call it a course, to price this webinar or a CD of interpersonal skills at a very affordable price so that everybody can take it. So it's there for you guys to purchase. The interpersonal video is almost around 2 hours long and it's available for purchase. It's $25. Yes, that is a real steal. I think in pounds, it's almost around £20. In the world of PLAB, where everything is super expensive, this is a steal. I wanted to keep it this cheap because I wanted everybody to get their hands on this CD and definitely improve their interpersonal skill and really learn of what interpersonal skill means and apply that when they're doing their PLAB 2 exams. So whether you're doing your PLAB 2 exams, whether you're doing any course, or whether you're planning to do your PLAB 2 exams, it does not matter. This CD applies to everybody. You can learn what interpersonal skill means and how to apply it, and use the rest of the information from any other course that you're doing and improve yourself fully to pass these exams. If you guys are interested in purchasing the interpersonal skill webinar that I've done, make sure you send us a message on our Facebook page, Dr. ZZ. Send us a message saying, "Hey, Dr. ZZ, I would like to purchase the interpersonal skill video," and one of our operators will help you guys with it. At the end of the day, whatever I said and done, it is time and time understood. The examiners have said that. I'm telling you, interpersonal skills is something that is very important that will help you to pass these exams. And also one more thing, guys, do not wait till the last moment to improve interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills take time to develop. After watching this video, there will be so much information that you get. You'll have to slowly apply this information while you are practicing with your friend or whoever. You have to apply those concepts, and those concepts takes time to develop. So even if your exams is far away, make sure you get your hands on it and practice these concepts and become good in your interpersonal skills. If you guys enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up, share this video with one of your friends who's planning to do PLAB 2, subscribe and comment in the comment section below. This is your boy Dr. ZZ. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take it easy. Peace.